इन दैट लेक्चर चैप्टर 10 सर्कल वी विल डिस्कस सम बेसिक क्वेश्चंस. बिफोर दैट थ्योरम्स इज प्रेजेंट इन योर माइंड. सो फर्स्ट थ्योरम ऑफ चैप्टर 10 इज दैट इक्वल एंगल सबटेंड इक्वल कोड एट द सेंटर एंड इफ कोड्स आर इक्वल देन सेंट्रल एंगल आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. इफ सेंट्रल एंगल आर इक्वल देन कोड मस्ट बी इक्वल. सेकेंड थ्योरम इज दैट इफ वी विल ड्रॉ द इन ए सर्किल O is the center. If we will draw any line segment from the center of the circle on the chord, which is perpendicular that, they divided in two equal parts also. वो two equal parts में क्या करेगा? और divide करेगा. A, B, P. So if OP is perpendicular on AB, then AP is equals to PB. Or its converse theorem, if AP equals to PB, then OP is perpendicular on AB. Perpendicular, then divided it into two equal parts. And if divided it into two equal parts, then after perpendicular. Now next theorem is that two chords AB, second chord is CD. From center distance O, X and OY. If OX is equals to OY, distance from the center to the chords are equal. Meaning is that if chords are equidistant, then the length of the chord must be equal. Chord ki distance center se क्या है इक्वल देन द कोड मस्ट बी इक्वल. इट्स कन्वर्स थ्योरम इफ कोड्स आर इक्वल देन डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम देयर सेंटर मस्ट बी इक्वल. ओके सो इफ द कोड्स आर इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्किल देन द कोड लेंथ मस्ट बी इक्वल. इट्स कन्वर्स if the chord length are equal then the chords must be equidistant from center of the circle. Next theorem is that from three non collinear points point A, point B and point C, how many circle will pass? Students, from three non collinear points how many circles will pass? Only one circle will pass. How? Perpendicular bisector of that one, perpendicular bisector of that one. O, join O to A, O to B and O to C and taking O as a center and construct a circle. Then we will obtain. After that, next theorem, which is related to the angle at the center and angle at the remaining part of the circle. A, B, C and O. Here, angle ABC is angle at the remaining part of the circle. Here, angle ABC is an angle at the remaining part of circle. And angle AOC is an angle at the center. Then what we conclude here? Angle EOC is equals to twice of angle ABC over angle ABC is equals to half of angle AOC. सेंट्रल पे एंगल फॉर्म होगा दैट इज जस्ट डबल the angle which are forming at the remaining point on the circle and the angle which are forming at the remaining part of the circle is half of the angle which are forming at the center of the circle. Let that angle is given to you 170. If angle AOC is equals to 170, then find angle ABC. So here students, angle AOC is 170 degree. Then how we'll find out angle ABC? Using theorem, we know that angle ABC is equals to half of angle AOC. So angle ABC is equals to half. What is the value of angle AOC? That will come 85 degrees. So that angle value will come 85 degrees. Or its converse question is that if angle ABC is equals to 60 degree, then find angle AOC. So students, here angle at the remaining part of the circle is given to you. Then how we will find out the angle at the center? So angle AOC is equals to twice of angle ABC using theorem. So what is the value of angle AOC? 2 multiply 60 is equals to 120 degree. Now next type of question based on that theorem. A B C O. Student, listen, given to you that angle is 80 degree, then find the value of X. Here angle E O C is equals to 80 degree, then find X. So here student, angle A O C is given to you. Then how we will find out the value of X? So to apply that theorem, firstly we will find out the angle or reflex angle of angle AOC, downward angle. So first of all, we will find out the reflex of angle AOC. A reflex of angle AOC is the downward angle. And how we will find out the reflex of any angle? That we will subtract from 360. So 360 minus 80, that will come 280 degree. 280 degree will come. Now using theorem, a reflex of angle AOC is equals to twice of angle ABC. The angle which are forming at the center of the circle is double the angle which are forming at the remaining part of the circle. So reflex of angle AOC is 280 degree, 2 multiply X. So what is the value of X? 280 upon 2, that will come 140. So X value is 140 degree will come. Understand? So these different types of questions are given to you. Then firstly you will identify that which theorem we will use here, then after apply. Next type question, next theorem, the angle which is forming in a semicircle is 90 degree or not? If here AB is the diameter and point P, we are forming here that angle. So that angle is always 90 degree. The angle which are forming in the semicircle is a right angle. Always remind in your mind. And if given to you, suppose if
पी इज इक्वल्स टू पी बी देन फाइंड एंगल पी ए बी दैट एक्स. ए पी इज इक्वल्स टू पी बी देन हाउ वी विल फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. एनी वन कैन टेल टू मी ए पी इज इक्वल्स टू पी बी इज गिवन टू यू देन हाउ वी विल फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स. No, x plus 90 degree. Here, in triangle APB, AP is equals to BP. AP is equals to BP. So triangle is isosceles triangle. So angle PAB is equals to angle PBA. PAB किसके इक्वल होगा? PBA दैट इज ऑल्सो x. इफ इन ट्राइंगल टू साइड्स आर इक्वल देन द एंगल अपोजिट टू इक्वल साइड्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल दैट इज x. नाउ यूजिंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी, यूजिंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी, यूजिंग एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी 90 प्लस x प्लस एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू 180 डिग्री, 2x इज इक्वल्स टू 90 डिग्री, सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स विल कम 45 डिग्री. सो क्वेश्चन में आपको ये गिवन नहीं होगा दैट इज 90 डिग्री, लेट्स यू सेल्फ आइडेंटिफाई दैट एंगल विच आर फॉर्मिंग इन ए सेमी सर्किल इज ए राइट एंगल. नेक्स्ट थ्योरम इज दैट एंगल्स इन द सेम सेगमेंट आर इक्वल. Angles which are forming the same segment. A, B, P, Q. Here, that angle X and that angle Y. Angle X is also forming angle with respect to AB and angle Y is also forming with respect to AB. So here angle AQB and second angle APB both are in same segment. So angle AQB is equals to angle APB. So angle X is equals to angle, that theorem is also. So the angle which are forming at the same segment are having equal a value. देखो इस पे क्वेश्चन कैसा हो सकता है. Suppose that A is 75 degree. If angle X is 75 degree, then find angle Y. Then here angle X is equals to angle Y. X क्या है 75, then angle Y also what will come 75 degree. You will mention here a reason. और reason क्या mention करोगे? Using theorem. Understand? Next theorem is that based on cyclic quadrilateral. So students, what is the cyclic quadrilateral? A quadrilateral whose all four vertex are lying on the boundary of the circle, that is known as cyclic quadrilateral. Cyclic quadrilateral. A, B, C, D is a cyclic quadrilateral because its all four vertex are lying on the boundary of the circle. in cyclic quadrilateral properties is that angle A plus C is equals to 180 degree and angle B plus angle D is also equals to 180 degree. Meaning is that in cyclic quadrilateral, its opposite angles are supplementary to each other. And supplementary ka meaning kya hai? Sum of its angle is 180 degree. That angle and that angle sum x, y, z, w. So x plus y is also 180 degree and w plus z is equals to also 180 degree. Second property is that in cyclic quadrilateral, the exterior angle is equals to its opposite interior angle. In a cyclic quadrilateral, A, B, C, D and E, that exterior angle is equals to its opposite interior angle. Angle X is equals to angle Y. So in a cyclic quadrilateral, first property is that sum of its opposite angles are supplementary to each other. Second is that its exterior angle is equals to its opposite interior angle. For example, suppose that angle is given to you 70 degree and that angle is given to you 75 degree. Then find angle C and X. You will find out the value of angle C and X. So how we will find out the angle C value? We know that angle A plus C is equals to 180 degree. Mention the property in cyclic quadrilateral, its sum of opposite angles are 180 degree. So angle A is 70 plus C 180, angle C is 180 minus 70 is equals to 110. So that angle will come 110. Next, now angle Y is equals to angle X due to the property of the exterior angle in a cyclic quadrilateral. So angle Y 75, X also 75, and in this way you can find out value of that angle also. Okay, iski bhi aap easily calculate kar loge, sum of opposite angles kya hoga, 180 degree, so that will come 105. So in cyclic quadrilateral, how you will prove that given quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral if the sum of its opposite angles are 180 degree? Then we can say given quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral. And if given quadrilateral is a cyclic quadrilateral, then the sum of opposite angles are 180 degree and its exterior angle is equals to its opposite interior angle. So students, these are the all about questions based on the circles. So today after watching that one, you will do solve the MCQs, one word type question, fill in the blank questions from R.D. Sharma books. In R.D. Sharma, many MCQs are given to you, many fill in the blanks are given to you, and many short type questions are given to you. Then you will solve. Then in next lecture, we will continue with your chapter 14, statics, and chapter 15 is the probability. That we will discuss in next lecture. So if you are having any problem or any queries, then you will send to me pick of the question on my personal WhatsApp number. Okay, thank you all students. Okay.